to Bethlehem and report to me when you have found him. Bethlehem and report to me when you have found him, so that I may worship him too. Go to Bethlehem and report to me when you have found him, so that I may worship him too. Wait, Armani, who brung you? JJ? What's up, Trey? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, Y, no, W, X, Y, Z. Can't do the alphabet. Oh, yeah. Hello, hello.
evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Thank you so much for coming. Merry Christmas. Really excited to welcome you to the second annual, I believe it is, for Foothills Academy Christmas program. I know these kids, I haven't been involved whatsoever, but from what I hear, they've been practicing a lot. They're really excited. My kids are actually nervous about something, which is refreshing. And so I think we'll have a lot of fun. But thank you so much for coming. It's really cool to see all your faces here. To watch the kids and all they've been working on for the last month or so. Just a couple of things where you are having refreshments afterwards, so please feel free to stay for that. But to get us started, we're going to have Mr. Charlie Miller come and open in prayer. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Jesus, this is all for you. This is all for you. We can do so much. And thank you for everything you've gave us. And you've done so much for us. And thank you that we can come here tonight. Amen.
Advent is a time of hope, faith, joy, and peace. The word Advent comes from the Latin word Adventus, which means coming.
It says in the book of John that for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
As we remember the birth of our Savior this season, we prepare our hearts for the second coming. We hope our program is a small way to celebrate God's greatest gift to us all.
In the beginning, there was a Word. The Word was God. The Word was God. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us.
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. You will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be called the Son of Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of David. His kingdom will never end.
I am the Lord's servant. May it happen as you have said.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you. The child will be called the Son of God, for there is nothing that God cannot do.
Thank you.
I sure am tired today. Boy, I sure am tired today. It's not easy to be a carpenter. Measure, cut, sand, build. I sure am not sleep well tonight. Measure twice, cut once, measure twice, cut once.
Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. It is by the Spirit that she will have a son, and you will name him Jesus, because God is with us, because he will save his people from their sins.
So Joseph did as the angel said and took Mary to be his wife. They traveled to Bethlehem for the census. While they were there, Mary gave birth to Jesus.
Do not be afraid. I am here with good news, which will be for all the people. This very day, in the city of David, there has been a Savior born, Christ the Lord. And this is what will prove it to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger.
Let us go straight to Bethlehem and see what the Lord has made known to us.
They hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in the manger. When the shepherds saw him, they told Mary, Joseph and Mary what the angel had said about the child.
Look in the manger!
Sorry.
It is him, the king of the world! A Savior has been born!
When they left, the shepherds glorified God for all they had heard and seen.
Hey!
few years after Jesus was born, some men who studied the stars came from the east and arrived in Jerusalem. The wise men went to King Herod and asked,
"Where is the baby born to the King of the Jews?"
"King? What king? I'm the king!
We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him.
We have gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh."
King Herod was angry. He met secretly with the wise men.
"So, tell me when this first star appeared. Go to Bethlehem and report to me when you have found him so that I may worship him too."
When the wise men came to Bethlehem, they found the child with Mary and Joseph. They gave him costly gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They rejoiced and fell down to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords.
We give them a big hand. I think they can hear us in the back. Wonderful. Well, they had asked me to be the bridge from this section to the next section, and I severely underestimated the the job that is, because we're about to enter into Christmas trivia. Fathers of the students, we're going to start with you. Come on up here. They're going to get back there changing. So if you have a student at Foothills Academy, come on up. Don't be bashful. We're going to play a little Christmas trivia and move on into the next part. So, and I knew I wouldn't get volunteers, so this is my way of doing it here. Give these motley men a round of applause. All righty, guys. Face the audience. Turn around. It's not your first time. I've got five cards in my pocket. None of them are really trivia about the Christmas story, of course, because we all know that one really well. It's just odds and ends. You're going to pick a number between one and five. Mr. Derek, he's right here. He can go first. I will read that question. All have gift cards according to difficulty. If he gets it wrong, pay attention to what card it is, because if he gets it wrong, that question will still be in play. Does that make sense? Any questions? Derek, introduce yourself. Maybe tell the people who your children are in the crowd, on the stage.
So I'm fortunate enough to have Theo and Quinn, and their last name's Overhaul.
What card would you like, sir? Number three, if I can get it out of my pocket. Let's see what we got here. You are allowed to get, I need silence from the audience. Other than one person can help you. If you can zero in on somebody that you think would.
So I can ask one person.
Yeah, like a lifeline.
Okay.
Yeah. Here we go. I gave these to my wife earlier, and this was one of the easier ones, but no pressure. What company or brand has been using Santa in holiday advertising since 1931?
Anybody out there? I had. So now what?
Yeah. I mean, you want to.
My guess would have been Coca-Cola.
That is correct. Give them a round of applause. I think there's a gift card in there for you. Oh, yeah. Yes, you're good. Your job is accomplished. Next, who's the next man up? Three is out. We got one, two, four, and five. Who are you, and who are your children and or child?
I'm Jeff Bontrager, and Oakley Bontrager is one of the wise men. But
one of the wise men. What's it going to be, Jeff? Number four. Best of luck. Who's the person you're going to zero in on for your help? Oh, Jeff, my six-year-old knew this one. How well are you familiar with the Grinch?
Seen it a time or two.
Okay, we're looking for the song, which is also in the movie, I'm sure. In the song, "You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch," how cuddly is Grinch? Again, you got a lifeline out there. How cuddly. Yeah, she's getting changed, I'm sorry. Out there? Anybody out there to
call him Kara?
Kara.
Cactus, final answer.
Winner chicken dinner. Might need to give her the gift card, but come on up. Who are you, sir?
Gabe Temple, and I've got two kids here, Mamie Temple and Beatrice Temple.
And you know the teacher, I believe, as well, right?
Married to the teacher.
Our favorite teacher. Give him a hand. It's all because of him. He can. She allows him to do. He allows her to do this, right? One, two, or five, Mr. Gabe.
Number one.
Best of luck. Ooh, tough one, Gabe. Tough one. What country did the tradition of putting up the Christmas tree originate? How many countries are there in the world? Yes, you do. Mom, help him out.
Yeah, I'm not going to go against her.
That is correct. Oh. Germany. How do you know that, ma'am? Done. Done. Good job, Gabe. Three for three. Some of you are going to be off the hook if we're not careful. And I hope the kids are dressed soon because I'm about out of questions. Sir, who are you and who are your kids up there?
Name is Dwayne Helmuth. I got the child who attends the school is Harper Helmuth. She's my youngest. And the two that are narrating, Ayla and Samantha, are my daughters as well.
Beautiful.
Two or five, Dwayne? Number five. No pressure, but three for three here. Goodness. Did not anticipate this. There's two answers to this question. I'll take either one. What is the best-selling Christmas song of all time? I'll take the artist or the song, or I have an extra bonus gift card if you can get both of them. Who's your help out there? We've got a shy hand here. Bing Crosby? Gonna take it? Bing Crosby is correct. What song? White Christmas it is. Dwayne, four for four. I got another one here for you. You can give your help this one maybe. Guys, five men, just one card remaining. Who's it going to be? Who are you and who is your child on the stage?
I'm Javen Miller. My child is Charlie Miller, one of the wise men.
One of the wise men. This is another tough one. I mean, I thought a couple of them were tough, but what do I know? What is a popular Christmas song that was originally written for Thanksgiving? Yeah, this is your guys' question, so. Want to just take a wild jab or guess on your own?
Amberlynn.
Yeah.
Is it Jingle Bells?
It is Jingle Bells. Give him the hand. I'm sorry, guys. Jeepers. Guys just ran through it. The audience was the key ingredient there. Would you be so kind to give the children a wonderful round of applause as they come back to the stage?
job, guys. Let's give them another round of applause. I'm Jamie Temple, the director at Foothills Academy, and also have the pleasure to teach these amazing kiddos. It's a real special group we have here. They've worked really hard to put this show on, and y'all rocked it. Good job. We would not be able to do this without our music director, Sheila Nault. Also without Jerry and the sound team. And a special thanks to Christina Chumbler for providing some of the music too. Thank you, Christina. Thank you guys for coming. It's a real special night to put on this program, and we really enjoy having you here. I know the kids do as well. We will have refreshments out in the lobby, and y'all stick around, hang out. We do ask that y'all keep the food in the lobby. Don't let kids go to the gym or the sanctuary with any hot chocolate or food, please, if you don't mind. Thank you for coming again, and we'll close in prayer. William Byler will close us.
Dear Lord, thank you for everything that you gave us, and I bless you. This was all for you, and everything that is here, you're welcome in it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Just see.